Let's get something straight.
It's time for another 2-Minute Tech Tip.
Hi, my name's Phil Wilkins. I am an OICS associate and co-author of Implementing Integration Cloud Services.
My name is Robert from Molken. I'm integration consultant at Amis and co-author of the book Implementing Oracle Integration Cloud Service.
And the clock starts now.
We're going to look at a simple integration using two connections, one REST to trigger and one SOAP to target, and we're going to integrate them using a simple basic map data.
So we start with finding our connections that we made. We can easily filter on 2-minute tactic. Then we have our REST and SOAP connection. So we start with our REST connection. We fill in our details for the get flight with a URI for getting the schedule on the flight ID, and we need to fill in our request and response. So because we set in the URL flight ID, we pick the string, and we can pick that from a drop-down list, other types. And then we click on next, we select the response. We do that based on an XML schema. That's the same one our target uses. And we select result, the get schedule result, and the JSON as a response type instead of XML. And then we finish our, and we start with the SOAP. We select our connection, and then we see that we have only have one method and we don't have headers, so we can say no. And then we can just finish our the wizard.
And we jump to the mapping for the source to target, and we route the whole mapping across, and now we can go and do the target response back to the original source. Because we're mapping the same attributes, we can just drag and drop the top ones. Now we need to set up the tracking ID, so when the integration runs, it records the IDs of the event. Finally, we need to save and activate the integration. Once activated, we can see the URL and the request and response operations, and then we can call the URL and get the result.
What did you think of that tip?
Oh, you've made me so happy.
We want your opinion. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned.